Learn 100 ways to generate income online. Learn 100 ways to make money online. Introduction: if you've been on the internet for more than a few hours, you've likely seen at least one advertisement teaching you how to make thousands of dollars a minute, working from your underwear, in the comfort of your own home. These ads are so ridiculously popular that if you're like most people, you start doubting whether it really is possible to make money online. The truth is, it is possible. It might be hard to make thousands of dollars a minute from the get-go, or at all, but there are certainly ways you can make money working from home with ease. In this report, I am going to share 100 different ways in which you can create more income. I have tried to cover all types of methods for all different personality and skill types, and I am confident that you'll be able to find at least a few that sound good to you. While some of them require more work than others, please know that you can mix and match. For example, maybe you can do a few hours of forum moderation at $10 an hour for $30, and then make up the extra $70 doing something else. The key is to have fun and do whatever you enjoy. I have given an overview of each idea, and then fleshed them all out a little bit so you could get started on whatever you like, immediately. It is my sincere hope that you get a lot out of this report, and that you take action and start making money. Without any further ado, let's get started. 1. Forum posting. One of the easiest ways to make money online, if you have a flair for talking, is by forum posting. A lot of webmasters have started hiring people to post on their forums so that their forums look busy and popular. They feel that by making their forums look more popular, they will be able to attract more long-term visitors. When you're posting in forums, all you would have to do is initiate new threads, or respond to existing ones, and keep conversations going. You may do this by posting interesting thoughts, thought-provoking conversation, or teaching people things. A cool perk of this job is that you get to learn new things. Also, if you post in forums that you're already interested in, you basically get paid to have fun. In order for you to become a forum poster, here are some steps you can take: browse through freelancing sites such as Elance.com, Guru.com, Odzke.com, etc. Apply for forum posting jobs on those sites. Respond back to the buyer on time if you are called for an interview. Agree on the pay per post and the deadline. Get the job done within the accepted deadline. How much can I make out of forum posting? For each forum post you make, the general prices range anywhere from 10 cents to 50 cents per post. If you have time to devote to this during the day and are able to make between 200 to 1000 posts, depending on how much your job is worth, then you can earn $100 a day. You can also, of course, do whatever you would like per day and then mix and match with another suggestion from our lists. 2. Forum moderator. As long as forums exist, forum moderators need to exist. This is because webmasters need people to block negative comments, make sure things are running smoothly and forum users are getting their questions and comments responded to. To be a forum moderator, you would need to monitor comments posted by users, delete spam, answer questions from users, and reply to user messages. You would also encourage threads, add new content to the site, and block comments posted by people who ignore forum rules. If you have an interest in certain forums, this could be very interesting for you to do. Just like with forum posting, you also have the potential to learn a lot. You can find further tips here. In order for you to become a forum moderator, here are some steps you can take: post a profile on freelancing sites such as Elance.com, Guru.com, and Odzke.com. Describe your interests and your levels of expertise. Look for forum moderator jobs on the same freelancing sites, and apply for them. Google forum moderation job openings. If there are forums you're interested in, check with the owner. A lot of people don't post on freelancing sites but rather prefer to hire people who post a lot. How much can I make out of moderating forums? Depending on your role and experience, you can make anywhere from $3 to $20 an hour. 3. Article writing. If you are a good writer, you can earn money by writing articles for people with websites. Many website owners know that they need to keep their websites current and up to date, but don't have the time to constantly create new content for them. Because of that, they hire people who can write on their behalf. In order for you to become a content writer, here are some steps you can take. Post a profile on freelancing sites such as Elance.com, Guru.com, and Odzk.com. Describe your interests and your levels of expertise. Email support at BernieRTodoList.com with your name and include a writing sample. We are constantly looking for more writers and will give trial work to all eligible writers. Look for writing jobs on the same freelancing sites and apply for them. Google Writer Job Openings. Ask the owners of websites that you already like if they are looking for writers. How much can I make out of writing? Content writing jobs pay anywhere from $1 to $100 plus based on the length of the article and your expertise. If you're already an expert on the topic you're writing about, you can often charge a premium. Even if you are new to writing, you can make upwards of $0.50 for each 100 words on an article. 4. Become a blogger. If there's something you're passionate about, you can create a blog where you can talk about it. This is a fun way to share your passions while learning and teaching about what you're already excited about. In order to do this well, you would need to be a good writer with the ability to make people interested. You would also need to be able to post fairly regularly to a blog. Blogs can be monetized in several ways. Just some ways are to have companies pay you to post their advertisements. This is better for blogs with a lot of traffic, or put Google AdSense on your blog. With this option, Google pays you every time someone clicks on an advertisement. In order for you to become a blogger, here are some steps you can take. Choose a company to blog with. Two of the most popular ones are Blogger or WordPress. Decide if you want a free account or if you would like to host the blog on your own domain. If you bought a domain, your blog could like www.yourpassion.com, or a free account would look like www.yourpassion.wordpress.com. Most people opt to buy a domain so that their blog appears more professional. If you choose to do this, you'll need to sign up with a hosting company. I recommend HostGator. Their plans are as low as $4.95 a month, and then have your domain routed to the hosting company. This may sound difficult, but it's actually very easy, and HostGator's customer support can help you with any questions. After your blog is set up, decorate it however you would like. WordPress calls the blog skins themes, and Blogger calls them templates. Post news, lessons, stories, or anything relevant to your blog. Add content as frequently as possible so that you build up a regular readership base. Start advertising your site on social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. How much can I make out of blogging? It can take some time to establish a blog, but the profit potentials can be quite large. Some people report making in the millions of dollars from a blog. Your earnings will vary based on traffic you get to the blog, how interesting your content is, how often you post, and the types of advertisements you put on your blog. 5. Guest writer. Webmasters sometimes need specific experts to create content for their websites. They might not know enough about a specific topic, or want to have someone else's insight. If you're an expert in any particular niche, you can make some excellent money by writing in and offering your wisdom. In order for you to become a guest writer, here are some steps you can take. Make sure to establish yourself as an expert in your niche by making a presence in the websites and forums in your area of interest. Sometimes, people will just ask if you're interested in creating content. After you've established a presence, you can also write to website and forum owners and let them know what your expertise is and that you'd be interested in creating content for them should they be interested. You can find more tips here and here. When you get a writing job, make sure your content is written and submitted as early as possible. If you establish a good reputation, you can get references for other sites and hopefully end up writing for more. How much can I make out of being a guest writer? Depending on the length of the piece you create and the obscurity of the topic, you can make anywhere from $25 to $200 each time you write. 6. Podcasting. Podcasting is similar to blogging, only you would do it via voice instead of typing. You would get the same benefits and approach it the same way, post regular content, etc. But it's just a way to suit people who would rather learn via listening versus reading. To get started with podcasting, you need a headphone, microphone, and software in which to record your audio. You can earn money with podcasting the same way you would with blogging, via advertisements, Google AdSense, and by recommending other programs that offer commissions. In order for you to become a podcaster, here are some steps you can take. Create a website with which to put podcasts on, record your content. You can use a free recording program such as Audacity if you don't already have something. Convert your recordings to MP3. Upload your MP3 along with a description to your website. Start sharing it. Get it converted into MP3 format. Upload the MP3 on your site. Add content as frequently as possible so that you build up a regular listener base. Start advertising your site on social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. 7. Online counselor. Many people like to go online for counseling instead of meeting people in person. They feel that they can be more anonymous this way, and they also have the convenience of not needing to drive anywhere. If you have the ability to counsel people effectively, this could be a fun job for you. You do not need to have a special degree, although it would obviously give you a cutting edge. In order for you to become an online counselor, here are some steps you can take. Create a website that discusses your qualifications and how you are able to help people. If you don't have a degree or qualifications to prescribe anything to people, let them know. Some people just want to pay you so that you can listen to them and they can vent their frustrations. Just make sure not to overstep what you can legally do. Start advertising your site on social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. Start building up your customer base. Do a great job, implement word-of-mouth referral programs, and start collecting testimonials from the people you help. How much can I make out of being an online counselor? Depending on your skill level, you can make from $100 to $200 an hour and upwards. 8. Translation. If you know any other second language, then it will help you make money by opting for translation jobs. This is another easy way to make use of your spare time and convert it into money. Especially if you know any of the languages for which translators are in huge demand. In order for you to become a translator, here are some steps you can take. You can get hired for translation jobs through any of the freelancing sites. There are many sites which provide translation services exclusively. You can submit your interest and get hired through any of those sites as well. Identify the sites which post all the jobs related to translation. Get yourself registered in those sites. You can start your own site and make people know about the translation services that you are ready to offer. How much can I get paid for translation jobs? You can get paid anything from 1 cent per word depending on the demand for the language. If the number of translators for the language are scarce, then you can charge a good rate per word. Are you interested in acting as an agent or intermediary? Do you have a knack for business and are good in dealing with people? Then listed below are some ideas that might suit you. 9. Outsourcing middleman. Many companies look to hire people in order to help them expand their web presence, to create content for their blog, or help assist them with other tasks. If you are good at managing people as well as marketing, you can act as an agent for some outsourcers. Identify people that can do certain work, and then advertise their services to other businesses. Mark up the price so that you can make a profit. In order for you to become an outsourcing middleman, here are some steps you can take. Browse through freelancing sites, forums, and websites to find people that you can hire. Create a website where you lay out the services your team can do, as well as prices and turnaround times. Start advertising your site on social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. Start building up your customer base. do a great job, implement word-of-mouth referral programs, and start collecting testimonials from the people you help. How much can I make out of being an outsourcing middleman? A lot of how much you can make depends on the type of services you offer, how many clients you can handle simultaneously, and how well you can market your services. 10 Employee Referral. Many companies will offer referral bonuses for people who can recruit excellent new employees for their organization. If you know a lot of people or have relationships with recruiters, this can be an easy way to earn some extra cash. You can also find potential prospects for companies by using the internet. In order for you to become an employee referrer, here are some steps you can take. More companies do have employee referral programs than don't, which means you have a lot of opportunity to help employees find potential jobs. If you're unsure if a company offers a referral program, give them a call and ask. You may want to start with your own company, if you currently have a job. Find out if the people in your network are looking for jobs. Go on freelancing sites like Elance.com, Guru.com, and Odzke.com, and check out the profiles of people there. Communicate with people that sound good, and see if they'd be interested in getting more regular work. Refer people to HR of the company you work with or other company that you're recommending them for. You will get paid if they get hired. You can also try to build up a relationship with external recruiters. If you can do this, then you can get a list of current job openings from them. This can be incredibly lucrative. How much can I make out of being an employee referrer? Bonuses are anywhere from $50 to the $1,000s of dollars. A lot of this depends on the type of position. The stronger the qualifications needed, the higher the referral bonus, as well as the company you're working with. 11. Become a website or domain broker. There are a lot of people interested in buying people's sites. They would like to buy sites so that they can own established websites without having to do the work on their own, or they see profit potential on sites, and so on and so forth. A lot of people would love to sell their sites, too, but don't know how. As a website broker, you can connect buyers and sellers to each other and take a percentage of the sale for making the introductions. In order for you to become a website broker, here are some steps you can take. Create a website outlining the basics of what you do. As you get buyers and sellers interested, update the website with what buyers are looking for and what sellers have. Don't put sellers' site details on your website, otherwise buyers can go around you to bypass your commission. Just put general details. Start finding people interested in buying or selling their sites. You can find these people by going on existing sites for buying and selling such as Flippa.com, Sitesell.com, or BuyZellWebsite.com. Even if people are already listed on one website, it doesn't mean they don't want additional help. Don't give out site details to buyers until you get them to sign paperwork saying that they won't go around you, sign a non-compete, and so forth. When a deal is made, collect a percentage of the profits. How much can I make out of being a website broker? You can make anywhere from $100 to the millions of dollars, depending on how valuable a site and/or domain is. 12. Start a forum posting website. As stated before, many webmasters want people to post in their forums. A lot of times they will hire just one person, but at other times, they want a lot of people to go in at once, but don't feel like hiring a lot of individual people. If you can pool up 5 to 10 forum posters yourself, you can provide a one-stop service where a webmaster can pay you and you can then go out and pay people individually. In order for you to start a forum posting website, here are some steps you can take. Create a website advertising your services. You can hire forum posters from any of the freelancing sites or by looking on forums where people are interested in working, such as work-at-home mom websites. How much can I make out of having a forum posting company? Obviously, a lot will depend on what you charge and how much you have to pay your employees, but you can easily make $100 per day by doing this after getting enough clients. 13. Referral exchange programs. There are many independent programmers who take a lot of work from clients. There are times when they have too much work to do and can't take on new projects, and so they have to pass on new jobs. You can create relationships with these people in order to take their excess work, and then either outsource it or do it yourself. On the other hand, if you have too much work to handle, you can refer it to other people and charge them fees for your references. No matter which way you decide to do this, you can profit. In order for you to do a referral exchange, here are some steps you can take. Get yourself registered in referral exchange forums, find people that are able to take last-minute work, find people that are in your industry and regularly accepting freelance work, decide on rates that you will pay people that give you work, and rates you will charge for outsourcing work, make sure to do a great job and to only refer people you trust, so that you can continue doing this without worry of hurting your reputation. How much money can I make out of referral exchange? The profits will change based on how much you charge for referring work, as well as what you pay people for giving you references. You also have to account for how much you charge to do the actual work. You can easily make $100 a day doing this though, once you build up your partner base. 14. Buying and selling links. In order to get higher search engine rankings on Google, a lot of people feel that they need to have a lot of backlinks pointing their site. Backlinks are basically links on other people's websites pointing to another site. When someone links to another person's website, it shows Google that their website is worth linking to, and so Google gives it preference for their search engine placements. The higher the search engine placement, the more publicity a business gets, so a lot of people try hard to get more links to their websites. Because so many people want links, you can profit on this by acting as an intermediary between people who are willing to sell links and people who are willing to buy them. In order for you to buy and sell links, here are some steps you can take. You can look for those who want to buy or sell links in forums of sites which talk about links, example, http://www.linkage.com. Make yourself aware of the link buying and selling guidelines. Market only valuable links, links that have high page rank on Google. You can also create a website advertising your services. Start advertising your site on social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. How much money can I make out of buying and selling links? It depends on the amount you charge for connecting people. You can also buy links on your own and then charge people for them, in which you can create your own pricing. You can make anywhere from $1 to $300 for a link, depending on how valuable the site is. 15. Resell SSL certificates. An SSL certificate is something that websites often use in order to prove that their website is secure. This certificate is digitally signed by a certificate authority that people already trust after they verify the identity of a secure site. Many website visitors need to know a site is secure before they submit payment or personal information, so webmasters need the SSL certificates. You can become a partner with any company that offers SSL certificates and resell them on their behalf. These companies will either sell their SSL certificates to you at a discount, and you can resell them, or they will offer you incentives based on the number of sales you make. You can find examples of such incentives here or here. In order for you to become a partner to resell SSL certificates, here are some steps you can take. Browse the net and make a list of companies that offer SSL certificates. Sign up for partnership account with the company. Identify potential customers and make the sales. Provide a list of number of sales you made for the month to the company. Enjoy the sales incentive. How much revenue can I make by reselling SSL certificates? If the company with which you have become a partner offer sales incentives, then it depends on the number of certificates you sell and how much that particular company is offering. If the company with which you have become a partner offer certificates at discounted prices for you, then your profit will be the margin that you keep for yourself. Share and get paid. Do you frequent eBay? Has selling products or junk occurred in your mind while browsing the site? If so, the ideas below may suit you. 16. Drop shipping. Some people hesitate to sell on eBay and other websites because they don't want to have to go through the pain of storing products, getting them packaged properly, and then shipping the products to customers. There is an alternative to that though, called drop shipping. If you opt to this, then you don't need to touch the products at all. All you would do is sell the products, and then once you make a sale, a wholesaler would ship it on your behalf as soon as you provide them the name and address of each customer. In order for you to do drop shipping, here are some steps you can take. Get yourself registered in eBay as a seller and slash or create your own website. Make a list of wholesalers who provide drop shipping. Make sure the drop shippers do not include their contact information on the packages they send out, otherwise customers can go directly to them in the future. You can find out about many drop shipping companies by going to this site. List the products that wholesalers can ship. Start advertising your site on social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. How much money can I make from drop shipping? The difference between the sale price and the wholesaler price will be the profit margin that you will enjoy. You can make anywhere from a few bucks to thousands of dollars per sale, depending on what you're selling. You can definitely make $100 a day or more with this. 17. Sell your unused items. If you have unused items, anything from old clothes to your grandmother's antiques at home, then try to sell those items on eBay. You've undoubtedly heard the saying, one man's trash is another man's treasure, and it could be quite possible to earn quite a bit of money while uncluttering your home. In order for you to sell your items, here are some steps you can take. Get registered in eBay as a seller. Set up your own PayPal account to receive the payment. Look around your house and identify your unused things that you would like to sell. List your items for sale on eBay. How much money can I make out of selling unused items? This depends on what you're selling, of course. You can make anywhere from a few dollars to thousands of dollars by selling your unused items. 18. Buy and sell items on eBay. If you frequent eBay, you can attempt to buy other people's items and sell them for a higher price. A lot of times people misspell their listings or don't quite know the value of what they're selling, so you can score bargains and then resell them for a profit. Another alternative is to buy items in bulk and sell them individually to various buyers at a higher price. You can do this either by placing an advertisement to attract those interested in selling their unused items or browse through eBay itself to buy and sell old items. In order for you to buy and sell other people's junk, here are some steps you can take. Go through eBay and see what items you can find. Purchase items which you think will sell well. Identify buyers who would like to purchase the items. You may also want to consider building up a website and advertising on places other than eBay. How much money can I make out of buying and selling junk? This will depend on the profit margins you create and the value of each item. You can make anywhere from a few dollars to a few hundred. 19. Sell other people's items on eBay on their behalf. In eBay you have an option to list items which are not yet in your possession. However, if you choose to do it, then you must ensure that you don't violate eBay's pre-sale item policy. The cool thing about this is that you can buy things online that are close to selling out, and then list them on eBay while you wait to get them. You can also sell your friends' items without needing to physically have them in your home. Another thing you can do is sell items before you buy them to gauge demand. This is a cool way to get extra profit without having to take on any risk. Some things you can sell are tickets. In order to sell other people's junk on eBay, here are some steps you can take. Get yourself registered in eBay and set up a payment method to receive the payment. Set up a virtual store as a buyer. Select few items from others who want to sell their items and list them in your product page. Identify potential buyers who would be interested in buying the product. How much money can I make by selling other people's junk on eBay? You can make anywhere from a few dollars to thousands of dollars by doing this. Share and get paid. 20. Write an ebook on buying and selling techniques in eBay. If you decide to do the aforementioned items with success and are a talented writer, then why not write an ebook about using eBay to make a lot of money? Though many people might be aware of eBay basics, they might still buy the book to look out for new ways. Make the ebook as simple and creative as possible. A well-advertised book can sell for a long time, and any profit you make will be pure profit as the product would be delivered digitally and there would be no shipping costs. In order for you to write and sell an ebook, here are some steps you can take. Once you get familiar with eBay, start writing an ebook explaining how to use eBay and make money with it. Try to keep the book as simple as possible to attract more buyers. Give a catchy title to your ebook. Advertise it for sale in eBay itself. Get the sale done and enjoy the profit. Start advertising your book on social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. How much money can I make by selling the ebook? It depends on the price of the book. It depends on the number of books sold. It depends on the customer feedback and review for the ebook. Do you have a lot of spare time? Are you interested in utilizing it to make money? Do online jobs interest you? If so, some of the ideas listed below might suit you. 21. Participate in paid surveys. This is one of the ways that a lot of students love to make easy and quick cash. When you work with paid surveys, you get paid to participate in surveys as well as share your opinion. While these don't pay as well as some other options, the earnings add up, and all work is very easy. In order for you to participate in paid surveys, here are some steps you can take. Identify legitimate paid survey sites. Get registered in few sites to start with. Let the company know about the type of surveys you would be interested to participate in. Start participating in as many surveys as possible. Share your honest opinion about the products. Send back the completed survey form at the earliest or within the deadline. You need a computer with internet connection. You need to have an opinion regarding the product. You should have some spare time to fill out the survey form and send it back on time. How much can I make out of paid surveys? You can make anything between $1 and $100 depending on the type of survey and the length of the survey. Other than money, you can also enjoy some freebies, discount coupons, lucky draw, etc. 22. Submit links to social book marketing sites on others behalf. Because there are so many websites online, it can be very difficult for webmasters to get their sites noticed and stay competitive. In order to attract more visitors and build traffic for their site, website owners sometimes decide to submit their websites to social bookmarking sites. Instead of doing it themselves, they often opt to hire service providers for a small fee to submit their website links on various social bookmarking sites. In order to submit links to social bookmarking sites on others' behalf, here are some steps you can take. Collect a list of quality social bookmarking sites which have many active members. Decide on a fee structure and create a way to collect payment. Try to find as many customers as possible. Start advertising your book on social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. Get the website links submitted on time. Provide clients with reports on the number of sites you submitted and the links you have created for the customer from time to time. How much can I make out of social bookmarkings? You can make earn between $10 per each set of 100 social bookmarkings, and slowly increase the rate you charge based on your expertise. 23. Take up part-time data entry jobs. A lot of companies have random requests for different things, such as converting hard copy data to electronic data. If you have fantastic keyboarding skills with great accuracy, then why not make money out of it? In order for you to become a part-time data entry operator, here are some steps you can take. Look out for data entry openings in freelancing sites such as Elance.com, Guru.com, and Odesk.com. Start applying for those jobs. Get the documents done on time. Do the job as accurately as possible. Submit back the given job within required deadline. Collect testimonials and offer incentives for people to refer their friends. How much can I make out of data entry? You can make anything between $1 and $5 per hour depending on your speed and difficulty of the job. 24. Get hired as virtual assistant. Individuals who run their own business often find it very difficult to manage and organize things by themselves. By working as a virtual assistant, you can help people schedule meetings, organize day-to-day activities, answer phone calls, etc., and so on. If you are good at research and organizing things, then you can opt to get hired as virtual assistant. In order for you to become a virtual assistant, here are some steps you can take. Look out for virtual assistant openings in freelancing sites such as Elance.com, Guru.com, and Odesk.com. Start applying for those jobs. Try to find as many customers as possible. Start advertising on social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. How much can I make by acting as a virtual assistant? You can make anywhere between $3 to upwards of $100 per hour depending on your ability and experience. 25. Participate in contests. If you have a lot of time to spare, then you can start participating in contests offered by various sites. It's obviously likely that you won't win all of the contests, but the more you participate, the better your odds. Little things do start earning up, and besides money, you can possibly win things like movie tickets, sample products, gift coupons, etc. Where do I look for contests? Browse through the net and make a list of sites which offer contests. Get registered in those sites and check for new contests daily. Participate in as many contests as possible. Browse through the search engines regularly and look for any new contests. What do I gain by participating in contests? You can win cash as well as other perks like gift cards, coupons, and trips. 26. Editing and proofreading jobs. There are times in which articles or reports need to be edited and proofread before they're ready to be published online. If you are a native speaker of whatever language a client needs a document proofread, or have good command over that language, then you can pick up editing and proofreading jobs. In order for you to obtain editing and proofreading jobs, here are some steps you can take. Get yourself registered in all the freelancing sites such as Elance.com, Guru.com, and Odesk.com. Get yourself registered to websites which provide editing/proofreading services to their customers. Check job postings daily and apply to ones that you are qualified for. Get hired and start earning. How much can I make out of editing/proofreading jobs? Many people view this as a very crucial job and will pay for it. You can get paid per article or by the hour. If you go with the latter route, expect at least $5 an hour for it, upwards to about $20 an hour. 27. Email and phone handling. This is similar to a virtual assistant position, but doesn't require making appointments or needing any extensive skills. To do email and phone handling, you would mostly do things such as cold calling, answering queries over phone, and handling emails. Business owners generally tend to hire support staff to handle these tasks, as they're often too busy to do them themselves. This is one of the simple ways to earn additional income along with your regular income. In order for you to obtain email and phone handling jobs, here are some steps you can take. Get yourself registered in all the freelancing sites like Elance.com, Guru.com, and Odesk.com. Check job posts to see what people are looking for and apply for the jobs that demand your skills. How much can I make out of email/phone handling jobs? You can expect anything from $3 to $10 per hour depending on your experience and if there are any skills you should know about beforehand. At times, very rarely, you might need to know about complex topics. Share and get paid. 28. Browse the net and get paid. It might sound a bit hard to believe, but you can get paid to surf the internet. If you install a company's software, they will often pay you to keep it on while you are surfing the web. The reason the companies do this is so that they can track your activity and figure out what sites their users go to, as well as figure out how to market. The downside of this one is that sometimes you'll start finding random advertisements popping up, so do your due diligence and get a pop-up blocker, can be found for free by running a Google search. In order for you to browse the net and get paid, here are some steps you can take. Browse through the net and make a list of companies that pay you to surf the net. Here's a listing from Yahoo that gives a good amount of companies. Download and install their tracking software. Browse through the net and start earning. How much do I get paid? Companies pay you something around 50 cents per hour you browse and pay you something around 5 cents or 10 cents for every referral you provide. 29. Click on ads and get paid. Some companies will pay you to click on their advertisements in hopes of you liking the content on the other side. You can earn money for every ad you click, and this requires no skills at all. Where do I find such companies? Browse through the net and make a list of companies that pay you to click on their ads, e.g. http://www.adverecash.net. Make sure the site is a legitimate one before you get registered. Get yourself registered in the site. Start clicking the ads and start earning. How much do I get paid? You get paid something like 1 cent per click, as well as get money for referring other people to the sites. Although you could make $100 a day on this, this one is intended to be one of the methods that you use along with other ones to earn a total of $100 per day. 30. Browse through freebie sites and get paid. There are a lot of freebie sites online that you can sign up to in order to get a lot of valuable free items. While these sites don't always offer cash, you can take the freebies and sell them to other people. Where do I find such companies? Browse through the net and make a list of companies that offer freebies. You can also go on forums such as MyCoupons or FatWallet to get ideas from there. Sign up for the offers you're interested in. How much do I get paid? Depending on the freebies you get, you can sell them for anywhere from $1 to $20 or so. 31. Software load testing. When a piece of software is almost finished with development, a company will hire people to test it out for them in order to find bugs and see how effective the software is. The company can take the information and improve their product before releasing it to the mass markets. In order for you to become a software load tester, here are some steps you can take. Browse through the internet and search for load testing jobs. Get yourself registered in freelancing sites like Elance.com, Guru.com, and Odesk.com, and look for such jobs. Get yourself registered in companies which offer exclusive testing services, example http://www.acutist.co.uk. You can even create your own site and list the services you offer. Start advertising on social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. Once you get hired, provide a detailed report on the system response to the company. How much money can I make as a software load tester? You can expect anything from $3 per hour depending on the difficulty of the job. 32. Game tester. Game testing is similar to software testing. With this, you would play and test out games in order to identify any possible defects. As a game tester, you would need to play the game step by step and should look for even the smallest of errors, if any, and provide a detailed report. The companies take this feedback to enhance their product before launching it to the public. In order to become a game tester, it's ideal for you to be a hardcore gamer. You should also know how to play the games effectively to identify the bugs in the software. For further tips, you can feel free to refer here. In order for you to become a game tester, here are some steps you can take. Browse through the internet and search for game tester jobs. Get yourself registered in freelancing sites like Elance.com, Guru.com, and Odesk.com, and look for such jobs. Get yourself registered in gaming sites. You can even create your own site and list the services you offer. Start advertising on social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. Once you get hired, provide a detailed and effective report on the bugs in the system. How much money can I make out of such jobs? You can expect anything from $5 to $12 per hour depending on the difficulty and the time involved. 33. Become an application tester. Application testing involves testing websites in all the browsers and in all operating systems to make sure that an application will work for any possible user. At times, application testers are given various scenarios to test different outcomes, i.e. go here, then here, then here. Further changes or enhancements will be done by a company based on the testing results that application testers provide. Some companies, like this one, only provide application testing services. In order for you to become an application tester, here are some steps you can take. Browse through the internet and search for application testing jobs. Get yourself registered in freelancing sites like Elance.com, Guru.com, and Odesk.com, and look for such jobs. Get yourself registered in companies which provide such services and let them know that you are interested in taking up such jobs. Example, http://www.mindtree.com/itservices/testing/testing.html. You can even create your own site and list the services you offer. Start advertising on social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. Once you get hired, provide a detailed and effective report about the application and its bug to the company. How much money can I make out of such jobs? You can expect anything from $5 to $12 per hour depending on the difficulty and the time involved. Do you have a passion for programming? Are you tech savvy? Can you get anything and everything done on computers? If so, you might like some of the ideas below. 34. Write software for resale, with rights. If you are very good at programming, this is a great way to earn extra cash. Because there are so many websites and different needs, if you can create a program that solves a need for clients, you can sell it for a good amount of money. You could also offer resale rights to the program, which allows other people to sell it and collect the commissions. If you do this, you can charge a premium. This is great if you're not a fabulous marketer but still want to earn a lot of money. In order for you to sell software, here are some steps you can take. First, understand the general needs of the buyer and write your software accordingly. On Selling Software does a great job of going into this. Ask in forums, or ask your friends or target clients, what they would love to have software for. Advertise your software in websites or forums. You can also advertise on social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. How much money can I make out of it? This will depend on the complexity of the software and how much you decide to charge for it. 35. Design or build websites for people. If you are good at HTML, graphics, and Photoshop, then web designing might be a great option for you to consider. In order to create websites, you just need some creativity and know-how of how to use the tools. You can often create impressive websites using templates alone, and people will gladly pay so that they don't need to take the time to figure out how to learn the programs. In order for you to become a web designer, here are some steps you can take. Look for jobs on sites like Elance.com, Guru.com, and Odesk.com. Make sure you clearly read over all job descriptions. Once you're sure you understand what a client is looking for and feel confident that you can do it, apply for the job. Make sure you deliver in accordance with the requirements. You can also advertise in websites or forums, social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. How much can I charge for web designers? You can get paid anything from $10 or more per hour, or sometimes you can charge per website. Websites often go for $100 or more per site, with more being added for custom designs, extra pages, and so forth. Share and get paid. 36. Writing web components. If you know Java and know how to write web components, you might want to take a shot at selling them. Sometimes, students are interested in purchasing things like drop-down boxes or combo boxes for different projects. Other times, webmasters want them done. You can either create components yourself or apply for piecemeal jobs. In order for you to make money with web components, here are some steps you can take. Look for jobs on sites like Elance.com, Guru.com, and Odesk.com. Make sure you clearly read over all job descriptions. Once you're sure you understand what a client is looking for and feel confident that you can do it, apply for the job. Make sure you deliver in accordance with the requirements. You can also advertise in websites or forums, social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. How much can I charge for web components? You can charge anywhere from a few dollars to the hundreds of dollars. 37. Create an automation software and charge for the service. Many people have begun becoming very interested in automation services or software where a task can be done for them without having to do as much manual work. Some examples of these pieces of software include automated software for article rewriting, for checking spelling/grammatical errors in the articles, for article spinning, for PDF to Word conversion, and so forth. Even though there are a lot of pieces of software out there already, there is still a lot out there that is ready to be identified. If you can identify the needs and create the software, you can make a pretty penny. In order for you to make money with web components, here are some steps you can take. Browse through the administration jobs in freelancing sites to get a fair idea about what sort of services are required. For example, you might see a specific job where someone is asking to extract a set of data from a particular site and populate it in Excel. If demand is high for a specific service, you can mass market a software. You might also want to create something for one specific buyer and charge them for it. Another option is to take jobs and charge the market rate as if it were manual work, but use your software to speed up the production. How much money can I charge for such services? If you decide to make mass market software, you can charge anywhere from $5 to thousands of dollars. Most software runs $100 or less. If you are providing the required services by yourself, then you can charge on a per-entry basis. For example, if you are collecting name and telephone numbers listed on a site, you can charge something like 1 cent per entry. Share and get paid 38. Modify and create additional functionality to existing software. There are times when existing software is good, but could really use certain improvements. You can make these improvements and either sell them to the company, or sell them to users of the programs. You can find out more right here. In order for you to make money with this, here are some steps you can take. You can start your own website and advertise on the services offered. You can advertise in websites or forums, social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. You can get registered in sites that offer similar services, check sites like Elance.com, Guru.com, and Odesk.com. To see if anyone is asking for this. How much money can I make? This will depend on the software you work with, how many modifications you make, and if you're being paid hourly or per project. You can expect $10 an hour or more, usually. 39. Create your own search engine. A fun way to earn extra money is through creating your own search engine. You can have friends and family use it, and then start advertising it to other people. You can also make niche-specific search engines, which would be very appealing to people who are passionate about specific things and want all the information they can get. You can learn more about how to create a search engine here. In order for you to make money with a search engine, here are some steps you can take. Invite friends, family, and acquaintances to both use your search engine and add content. You can also advertise in websites or forums, social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. Enjoy the advertising revenue. How much money can I make? Your revenue will depend on the number of advertisement clicks and visitors that come to your search engine. You can earn anywhere from $0.01 to $4 or $5 per click, depending on the niche that you're working in. 40. Provide uptime monitoring services. Webmasters generally want to make sure that their website is working as frequently as possible. If their site goes down for any reason, they want to know how long it was down and why. This is crucial for webmasters as a lot of times, their sites are their sources of income. Because of this, they hire people to monitor the uptime for their websites. You could use free uptime monitoring software, put in a website's details, download the reports, and provide them to a webmaster. Even though some webmasters know about this software, they'd still rather hire someone to do it for them so they don't need to think about it. In order for you to make money with providing uptime services, here are some steps you can take. Browse through the internet and download a free uptime monitoring software. Example, http://www.internetuptimemonitor.com, get yourself registered in freelancing sites like Elance.com, Guru.com, and Odesk.com and look for uptime monitoring jobs. Get hired and generate the report from the software from time to time. Provide timely reports to the buyer as agreed. Get the job done and get paid. How much money can I make? If someone knows about uptime monitoring, they probably also know about the free software they could use, so you're more being paid for saving them time than anything else. If you get a lot of clients and charge a monthly fee, even $10 to send a detailed report weekly, then get 300 clients, you could make $3,000 with just that. Another route to go is to explain to people who don't know about the software why uptime monitoring is so important, and then sell them. This should be an easier sale for you. 41. Answer technical questions for a fee. If there's something you're very strong in, then set up a website for yourself and allow customers to ask any questions they want. You can either charge a monthly fee or a per question fee, and then reply back to them within a reasonable amount of time. Because there are so many sites that provide answers for free, you want to make sure that if you do this, it's in something that you have extensive knowledge in and can really help add value with. An example of a site that does this is ExpertBee. In order for you to make money with answering technical questions, here are some steps you can take. Establish yourself as an expert by writing articles, creating a blog, or even possibly an ebook. Advertise in websites or forums, social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. How much money can I make? You could charge anywhere from $0.10 per question to $100 per question, depending on your expert level. You might also opt to charge a monthly fee for X number of questions per month, so that you have comfortable recurring income coming in every month. 42. Assist people in installation of applications. Many people are not tech savvy at all. A lot of people don't know how to do much more than check their email and browse the web, but want to create a website. If you are pretty competent at installations, you can easily make money by installing applications and/or software to people's computers. This is also one of the simplest jobs to make very quick money. Not everyone is tech savvy. Many of them are aware of only the basics of internet like browsing, email, etc. Such people might require assistance in getting applications installed into their system. If you are very good in those things, then you can provide such assistance for people for a service fee. In order for you to make money with doing installations, here are some steps you can take. Design a website for yourself and list down the services you offer. Advertise in websites or forums, social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. Get yourself registered in freelancing sites like Elance.com, Guru.com, and Odesk.com and look for such jobs. Provide the services and pocket the money. How much money can I make? You can make anywhere from $5 per installations and upwards. 43. Provide forum hosting services. If you know how to set up a server base, then you can provide forum hosting services. By doing this, you are allowing less technically savvy people to host their forums on your website. You can easily find free and excellent forums to install, such as this one. That script allows you to host multiple forums on one site. In order for you to make money with forum hosting services, here are some steps you can take. Design a website for yourself. Set up a server or get forum hosting script from http://www.phpbbhs.com/index.html. Advertise in websites or forums, social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. Attract people to host forums in your site by giving them attractive deals. Market your site by advertising in various websites which are frequented by people who are interested in hosting forums. Pocket the service fee. How much can I make out of forum hosting services? This depends on how much you charge customers. You may also choose to provide the forum hosting services for free and simply make money off of advertising revenue. You can use Google AdSense or you can charge people to post advertisements on your site. 44. Provide backup storage services offsite. Disaster recovery planning and data recovery during disaster is very important for every company. If you could set up or rent a server offsite and offer remote storage services for a company, then you could make a lot of money out of it. All you would do is host their files so that in the worst case scenario, they would have a backup. The more the storage space you offer, the more the money you could make. To see an example of this, check here. In order for you to make money with backup storage services, here are some steps you can take. Design an impressive website for yourself, set up or rent a server remotely, attract people to use your backup services by offering them attractive deals, market your services by approaching various companies which might use your services, provide day-end backups on day-to-day basis, ensure you have enough storage space to offer how much can I make out of backup services. First, decide if you would like to charge a monthly rate or based on the storage space utilized. If the data stored is huge, then charging based on the utilized space will help you make a lot of money. You can earn anywhere from $5 a month to hundreds of dollars a month. 45. Create templates for popular blogs/forums. If you are very creative and is good at designing templates, then you can design impressive templates for popular forums or blogs and start selling them. If your designs are appealing, then you can make a lot of extra money. In order for you to become a template designer, here are some steps you can take. Design an impressive website for yourself, upload a few sample templates in your site, advertise in websites or forums, social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. You could also design a niche-specific template and then approach people in the niche to see if they would be interested in purchasing your template. How much can I make out of such services? Templates usually go for anywhere from $10 to $500, depending on the complexity of each template. If you do one-off, custom design sites, then you can charge more. 46. Start an online virtual store. You can set up a store by using either dropshipping as we talked about earlier, or by selling something that you create. Some examples are homemade candles, scrapbooks, or quilts. You can either mass market items, or you can offer your services and have people pay you per order, and then only start acquiring the product once you get paid. So for example, once someone gives you money, you start knitting a quilt. In order for you to create an online virtual store, here are some steps you can take. Design a website for yourself and set up a virtual store along with payment methods. You can also register as a seller on eBay or Amazon. If you intend on drop shipping, identify wholesale dealers. You can run a Google or use this site. Otherwise, identify people who supply the materials you need for your own product. Start building your customer base. Advertise in websites or forums, social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. Enjoy the profit margin. How much money can I make out of an online virtual store? Your profit will be the difference between the price charged by the wholesaler and the price you charge the customer. It's hard to give an estimate on this since different products have considerably different prices. 47. Create an affiliate website. If you don't want to sell products, either with dropshipping or having your own products, then you could also consider becoming an affiliate. As an affiliate, you simply refer people to other sites and earn a commission every time a sale is made. You can become an affiliate for major stores like Target, Walmart, or Amazon, as well as very specific niche sites. In order for you to have an affiliate website, here are some steps you can take. Design a website for yourself and set up a virtual store along with payment methods. You can also register as a seller on eBay or Amazon. Alternatively, you could simply give reviews of products and then link people directly to the pages of the products that you are mentioning. Make sure that you're signed up on some affiliate sites. Some of the more popular ones include ClickBank and Commission Junction. Those sites are both directories and can give you more information about hundreds of merchants with affiliate programs. Start building your customer base. Advertise in websites or forums, social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. Enjoy the profit margin. How much money can I make out of an online virtual store? Some affiliate programs will pay per lead, anywhere from $0.20 to $100, while others charge a percentage of sales, while others pay a flat amount per sale. This is highly different for each type of program. 48. Build a directory listing. You can choose any particular topic, S, and build a quality directory on it. On the directory, you would create hyperlinks to all of the websites within whatever your directory is about. You can do this for free, and then place advertisements on your site, or you could charge people to be placed on your directory. In order for you to have an affiliate website, here are some steps you can take: decide on your business model and then begin setting up the site. If you decide to charge people to stay on your directory, make it worthwhile for them. Maybe you want to give them a few months for free as you build up traffic, or give some other perk that shows them why they should sign up with you. Start building your customer base. Advertise in websites or forums, social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. How much money can I make out of an online directory? If you decide to list websites for free, then you would be paid for advertisements, which range anywhere from $0.01 to a lot of money per click. You could also charge people to list advertisements on your site, anywhere from $20 a month to thousands of dollars, depending on how much traffic your site gets. You could also charge a monthly fee, anywhere from $5 to $50 to more for premium options, for people to simply have their site listed in your directory. Got a passion or talent for something? Interested in converting it into money? Then listed below are some of the ideas that might suit you. 49. Stock photography. If you are interested in photography, then you can take some interesting pictures and sell them as stock photos. Stock photography is simply the act of licensing your photos so that people can use them as they wish. This is a fun way to make money on a passion that you already have. In order for you to make money with stock photography, here are some steps you can take. Here is an excellent website that explains how to sell stock photography in an extremely detailed and concise way. Once you start taking the photos, build yourself up a portfolio. How much can I make out of stock photography? You can make anything from few cents to thousands of dollars depending on the demand for your stock images. You will generally be paid on a royalty basis, getting paid whenever someone buys your photos. You will earn more money if a corporation uses your picture versus just an individual using a picture for fun on a website. 50. Make money with misspellings. There are a lot of people who misspell domain names when they're looking for things, and get redirected to empty pages. You can buy the misspelled domains and redirect them to the right one, including your affiliate link. See number 47 for more info. You will get credited with affiliate commissions for doing nothing but capitalizing on the misspellings. In order for you to make money with misspellings, here are some steps you can take. Look for affiliate programs to join. Read the affiliate terms of service and make sure they're okay with you finding misspellings. Most are, but some aren't. Type in potential domains into Namecheap.com and see what misspellings you can find. Buy any domains you find and have them redirect to your affiliate link. How much money can I make? This is hit or miss. I have one misspelled domain that silently made about $2,000 one year. The domain was missing a letter from the brand name. You can leverage by buying a lot of misspelled domains and make a nice passive income, especially considering your investment is only $8.81. Google Namecheap coupon code when buying your domain if you buy it on Namecheap. 51. Shoot an interesting video and start selling it online. If you can shoot an interesting video, then you can sell it online and make money. Your video can be anything from an interesting event, video tutorial, demo video, and so forth. In order for you to make money with stock photography, here are some steps you can take. Make sure you have a good camera with quality lenses as well as a microphone, recording and mixing equipment, etc. Create your video. You can either create a website, or you can sell directly to sites like this one. How much can I make out of stock photography? If you create videos on demand for people, you could ask for a certain amount of money per minute, per hour, or per video. This can be very lucrative after you build yourself up a portfolio. 52. Invest in stocks. This is definitely one of the riskier ways to make money. However, some people believe the greater the risk, the greater the reward, so I am including it here. However, once you get familiar with it and start making the right decisions, you can make a lot of money out of it. In order for you to make money with investing in stocks, here are some steps you can take. Analyze properly before you invest in a company's stock. Do not keep buying and selling from one stock to another. If you buy good stock and know it for sure that the rates will increase over a period of time, don't ever sell it unless you have an immediate requirement. Understand the bullish and bearish trends. Take advice from experts in the area if required. Invest smartly. How much money can I make? It depends on the number and type of stocks you hold and the market trends. 53. Invest in buying valuable websites. You can make a lot of money by identifying small, valuable websites, and then buying them. If you can make even a few tweaks to improve profit and then hold on to the sites for a little bit of time, you can flip the sites and make more money than when you started. Not only can this be lucrative, but it can be really fun to find out about new niches and learn new things. In order for you to make money with buying and selling websites, here are some steps you can take. You can buy or sell websites in sites www.websitebroker.com or Flippa. You can also find sites by browsing the net and contacting website owners directly. Make sure to protect yourself by giving owners non-compete agreements and getting all your paperwork in order. Tweak the sites for maximum profit. Keep records of sales. Sell the site for a better price. How much money can I make? It depends on how valuable the site is and the profit margin. You can make anywhere from $50 to the thousands of dollars, depending on how well your tweaks go. Share and get paid. Are you an expert in Photoshop? Do you know all the tricks? If so, some of the ideas below might suit you. 54. Design and sell t-shirts. Create impressive images, logos, or compelling text via Photoshop. Get your creations printed on t-shirts and start selling them online. You can also make custom shirts for people. For example, some people might want their child or spouse's picture on a shirt. You can use Photoshop to do any touch-ups, and then sell the shirt for a premium price. In order for you to make money with designing and selling shirts, here are some steps you can take. You can get registered in any of the online shopping sites like Amazon.com, eBay.com, etc. to find customers. Tell your friends and family about your new venture. Design a website. Advertise in websites or forums, social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. How much money can I make out of it? You can sell t-shirts from $10 and upwards. 55. Design banners. If you're an expert in Photoshop or other image creation software, you can design website banners for different companies and websites. In order for you to make money with designing banners, here are some steps you can take. Start your own website and describe the type of services you provide. Advertise in websites or forums, social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. Get registered in sites which provide banner services to customers, such as Elance.com, Guru.com, and Odesk.com. Look for Photoshop jobs in freelancing sites. Provide quality designs and start making money. How much money can I make? Most companies will pay you a flat fee. You can charge anywhere from $10 to the mid-hundreds, depending on the quality of your services and your reputation. Other companies will pay you based on how many times your advertisement is clicked, which is much more rare. 56. Design company logos. Every company needs a logo to establish their brand strongly. You can design these logos and collect some pretty great profits. In order for you to make money with designing logos, here are some steps you can take. Start your own website and describe the type of services you provide. Advertise in websites or forums, social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. Get registered in sites which provide banner services to customers, such as Elance.com, Guru.com, and Odesk.com. Look for Photoshop jobs in freelancing sites, provide quality designs, and start making money. How much money can I make? Like with banners, this is highly dependent on your reputation in the field. You can charge anywhere from $10 to the hundreds of dollars. 57. Design cartoons for websites. Some website owners like to have different cartoons on their website, either in comic strip ads to illustrate a point, or just throughout their websites. You can also design cartoons for writers who want to illustrate their points. In order for you to make money with designing cartoons, here are some steps you can take. Start your own website and describe the type of services you provide. Advertise in websites or forums, social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. Get registered in sites which provide cartoon services to customers, such as Elance.com, Guru.com, and Odesk.com. Look out for sites that look like they could use your services and contact them. How much money can I make? It varies depending on the number of cartoons you provide and the demand for your cartoons. You can usually get at least $50 for a few designs, and then work your way up. 58. Know how to design a template for digital scrapbooking? Many people adore scrapbooking as a way to preserve their precious memories. While in the past, people had to use physical photo albums, a lot of people now love to go online and keep their memories in digital form. If you can create custom templates for people, or even make generally impressive scrapbook templates for the masses, you can have a very fun business. In order for you to make money with scrapbook templates, here are some steps you can take. Start your own website and describe the type of services you provide. Advertise in websites or forums, social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. Start selling your templates and make money. How much money can I make? You can charge from $5 upwards for scrapbook templates for the masses, or you can do custom ones for people from $20 and upwards. 59. Sell clip art. If you are good at graphics, you can make different clip art and icons to sell. Because webmasters generally have a need to make their websites look colorful and inviting, a lot of them are willing to pay for your designs. You can make custom designs for people based on their website and niche, or you can make clip art to sell to the masses. You can find more information about creating clip art right here. In order for you to make money with clip art, here are some steps you can take. Design a website for yourself. Create a portfolio for yourself, and display it on your website. Decide whether to sell your images as packages or individually. Advertise in websites or forums, social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. How much money can I make? This will depend if you want to charge per piece. You can go from $0.50 an image to much higher, or if you want to sell per package, which would then depend on sizes of the packages and your reputation in the field. 60. Design website security seals. Many online browsers feel a lot better when they see security seals on web pages. This makes them feel as if their personal information is secure, and is especially helpful when they need to add their personal or payment information into a website. If you know how to design security seals for sites that have SSL certificates, you can sell them for a good price. Here are some security seal examples. You can also refer to VeriSign for great marketing ideas. In order for you to make money with designing website security seals, here are some steps you can take. Design a website for yourself. Advertise in websites or forums, social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. You might also want to consider contacting website owners and offering your services. You might want to give some away for free so that new website owners have social proof and see that other people are using your seals. How much money can I make? As your seals gain more popularity, you can charge from $10 all the way to $300. 61. Create background templates for MySpace profiles. Everyone loves to express themselves, and MySpace is a perfect place to do it. Even though the site has lost some popularity, it is still very popular, and many users love having individual templates to express themselves. While there are plenty of free templates around, you can distinguish yourself by making custom-tailored templates for people that really express who they are. In order for you to make money with designing MySpace templates, here are some steps you can take. Design a website for yourself. Create 10 to 12 impressive layouts as samples. Create a variety to suit all types of people. Advertise in websites or forums, social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. You may also want to contact people with MySpace-related sites and tell them you will give them a cut of any sales you make. How much money can I make? You can reasonably expect $10 to $50 for your templates, depending on your skill level and reputation. 62. Edit or restore old photos. Most people love having lots of pictures in order to preserve their memories. However, since pictures fade away after a long time, there is often a need to restore them. If you know how to use Photoshop, you can restore the pictures for people and earn quite a bit of money. You can also give the photos touch-ups, add backgrounds, or do whatever else the client wants, for extra income. In order for you to make money with editing and restoring old photos, here are some steps you can take. Design a website for yourself. Advertise in websites or forums, social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. Tell your friends and family about your new services. How much money can I make? You can charge anywhere from $10 to $100 per photo. 63. Offer video montage services. This is another service in which you can make great money by helping people create memories. If you can take some pictures that a customer provides, put together a nice slideshow with background music, and burn it to DVD, you can have a great and fun business. These video montages would be great as unique presents for people that would provide lifetime memories. The more innovative you are, the more sales you will likely get. To get an idea of how some people market their montages, check here. In order for you to make money with video montage services, here are some steps you can take. Create a website for yourself. Post some sample video montages. Tell friends and family about your new service. Advertise in websites or forums, social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. How much money can I make? You can charge anywhere from $20 to $200 per montage. Are you an expert in search engine optimization? Are you interested in doing freelancing jobs? Then listed below are some of the ideas that might suit you. 64. Write SEO-optimized articles. Many people look for keyword-optimized articles in their niche to generate more traffic to their websites. If you have knowledge of SEO and can write keyword-optimized articles in any niche, then you can make good money out of it. In order for you to make money with SEO articles, here are some steps you can take. Get yourself registered in freelancing sites like Elance.com, Guru.com, and Odzke.com. Make a profile with samples of your previous work. Apply for article writing jobs. Email support at bernieourtodolist.com with your name and expertise. They are always providing trial work for quality writers. Write articles based on keyword requirements, submit them back on time, and get paid. How much money can I make? You can either charge a flat fee or hourly. If hourly, you can expect anywhere from $4 to $15 an hour. If by the article, you can charge from $0.01 word, low end, to higher. 65. Write interesting ebooks and sell them online. As everything goes digital, most people prefer to read books digitally instead of getting hard copies that take up space. Create a small ebook of 50 to 100 pages on any interesting topic and start selling it. In order for you to make money with your ebooks, here are some steps you can take. Create a website with a sales letter. Advertise in websites or forums, social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. Offer your book for sale in eBay, Amazon, etc. How much money can I make? It depends on the topic and length of your ebook. You can test out different prices from anywhere to $5 to $100 and see what sells the best. Share and get paid. 66. Write ebook for others for a service fee. A lot of people hire writers because they want ebooks created but feel that they're not good writers themselves, or because they want to save time. If you are a good writer and feel confident that you can write ebooks on lots of topics, keeping in mind that you can always do research, then you can start writing for a fee. In order for you to make money writing ebooks, here are some steps you can take. Get yourself registered in freelancing sites like Elance.com, Guru.com, and Odzke.com. Apply for ebook writing jobs. Include writing samples so people can gauge the quality of your work. Get the ebook written as required by the buyer, submit it back on time, and get paid. How much money can I make? For ebooks, you can charge between $2, very low end, to $25 per page based on your experience and expertise. 67. Rewrite ebook for others for a service fee. If you are good at rewriting articles, then you can take up ebook rewriting jobs. To rewrite an ebook, you need to go through the existing content and rewrite it in your own words without distorting its meaning. Rewriting can be much easier compared to original writing because it doesn't require any research. In order for you to make money writing ebooks, here are some steps you can take. Get yourself registered in freelancing sites like Elance.com, Guru.com, and Odzke.com. Apply for ebook writing jobs. Include writing samples so people can gauge the quality of your work. Get the ebook written as required by the buyer, submit it back on time, and get paid. How much money can I make? For rewrites, you can charge between $2 to $20 per page based on your experience and expertise. 68. Start teaching online. If you are an expert in any subject, start teaching online and make money from it. You can teach any topic to anyone in any part of the world. There is a constant requirement for online teachers, especially from US and China. A lot of students in the US need online help for random homework, assignments, etc. There is also a great demand from Chinese students who want to learn English. Another idea is to teach online computer classes to people. In order for you to start teaching online, here are some steps you can take. Browse through the internet for e-tutor jobs and start applying for them. Example, http://www.e-tutor.com, http://www.live-etutor.com, etc. Start your own website and list down the subjects you teach. Advertise in websites or forums, social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. Provide proper services for your students as agreed. Monitor results so you can mention them to new prospective students. How much money can I make out of such jobs? You can charge between $4 to $20 per hour depending on your experience and expertise on the subject. 69. Pool in e-tutors and offer tutoring services. Considering the demand for the number of e-tutors these days, it would be a great idea to hire a few expert tutors for all the subjects and offer professional e-tutor services. By having your own company, the odds are greater that you'll make more money versus working for somebody. In order for you to start tutoring services, here are some steps you can take. Hire some tutoring experts for various subjects. Make sure tutors have clear guidelines on the way you want them to behave. Design a website for yourself. Advertise in websites or forums, social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. Get feedback about the quality of tutors teaching from students and their parents. Make sure to constantly gauge feedback in order to have the best possible services. How much money can I make out of tutoring services? This depends on what you charge and how much you pay the tutors. If you charge customers $10 an hour and pay your tutors $5, for example, you would be on the lower end and making $5 an hour. Share and get paid 70. Take up online research work. With new businesses popping up every day, there is a constant requirement for internet research and data collection. This shows up in many ways. For example, before someone starts a new business, they generally like to collect some basic data about the business, its demand and supply, its profitability, areas or countries where it can run well, etc. People that are looking for this are ready to hire someone to collect such data and provide a report for them. They will use this report to decide if they should even begin the business. There are other types of research jobs available as well, and this can be a fun way to learn about a lot of new things. The decision to start with the business or not depends on the results of the research. Considering the need for the job, it is a good idea to take up online research jobs, if you are net savvy and have a lot of time to spare. In order for you to make money with online research work, here are some steps you can take. Get yourself registered in freelancing sites like Elance.com, Guru.com, and Odzk.com. Apply for web research jobs. Do in-depth research and provide a report as required by the buyer. How much money can I make out of such research jobs? If you work on fixed-price jobs, you can expect anything between $5 to $200 depending on the difficulty and the depth of research required. If you work on hourly jobs, you can charge anything between $3 and $50 depending on your experience. 71. Sell online learning videos. In this internet era, it seems as if everyone is interested in learning from home during their spare time. If you are an expert in a particular area, then you can convert it into money by creating a step-by-step instructional video. Try to make the video as simple and as easy as possible and start selling it. Just remember that people only want to buy quality content, so make sure that you're able to offer high-quality information that teaches people a lot. In order for you to make money selling instructional videos, here are some steps you can take. Start a website for yourself and start posting quality content to establish yourself as an expert. Record instructional videos and upload them to your site. Charge a fee to get the videos downloaded. How much money can I make? You can charge a few bucks to a few hundred dollars per video, depending on the information in the video and how readily accessible it is. Share and get paid 72. Offer software review services. Many programmers are ready to pay for outside reviewers as they need honest feedback about the programs they write. If you are an expert in software development, then you can offer honest reviews for programmers regarding their program or software for a fee. When you provide such services, make sure you provide an in-depth review about both the good aspects and the flaws. You can charge a fee based on the demand for your review and your expertise in the area, example, http://www.softwarejudge.com, http://philip.greenspun.com/software/design-review. In order for you to make money with software review services, here are some steps you can take. Write a few software reviews for free in order to show people the quality of content that you can provide. Use these as samples. Look at software forums and approach people who are creating new programs. Do a Google search to find potential prospects. How much money can I make? You can charge anywhere from $10 to the thousands of dollars, depending on your reputation and expertise. You could also consider having a company where many people do software reviews, and then you would create one large comprehensive report with everyone's insight for a company. This could net you significantly more profit. 73 Telecommuting jobs. If you are interested in working from home, then browse through the search engines and find telecommuting jobs. Example, http://www.tjobs.com. Identify the jobs which suit your talent and start applying for it. If you get hired, start working from home and enjoy the money. In order for you to make money with telecommuting positions, here are some steps you can take. Browse through the internet and look for telecommuting jobs. Get yourself registered in the sites which offer telecommuting jobs. Check the sites daily to find jobs that pique your interest and apply for them. How much money can I make? These jobs generally pay anywhere from $3 to $50 an hour. 74 Send out greeting cards on others' behalf for a fee. Many people like to surprise their close friends and relatives by sending out an unexpected greeting card. However, since people are more pressed for time than ever now, the number of physical cards sent has reduced, while the number of digital cards has increased. You can offer to send physical cards for people on their behalf so that they can still provide the fun gift of giving a physical, tangible card without having to worry about going to the card store and the post office. Just ask people for what type of card they would like, and then the type of message. You can handwrite the message in for a nice homemade feel. You can buy the cards and mail them out on their behalf, spreading joy for everyone. In order for you to make money with sending out greeting cards, here are some steps you can take. Create a website for yourself. Tell your friends and family about your new services. Advertise in websites or forums, social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. How much money can I make? To make this worth your while, you really need to get a lot of customers and do this in bulk. If you bought a $3 card and a stamp, you'd make $2.xx if you charged $6 per card. Obviously, the more you charge, the more you make. When you start getting a lot of customers, this can be lucrative and fun for you. 75 Refer your friends for paid surveys. You already know that you can earn money by filling out paid surveys. You can also earn money by referring people to those surveys. In order for you to make money by referring your friends to paid surveys, here are some steps you can take. Look for referral scheme in the paid survey sites that you participate. Refer your friends to those sites. Encourage your friends. Complete the surveys. Get paid for those referrals. How much money can I make out of referrals? You can get paid something around $1 or $2 for every referral you make. The rest of the entries are miscellaneous ways that you can earn money online. 76. Start flipping domains. Flipping domains is similar to what people do in the real estate business. First, you would buy a cheap domain for $9 or $10. If you get a good domain, you can flip it at a site like DN Forum or Flippa. Some people will be ready to pay a big price if the domain name is apt and keyword rich for their niche. For example, business.com fetched $7.5 million in 1999. Though there aren't as many domains available as there used to be, but great ones still exist. A lot of times people may not have thought of certain domain names themselves, but when they see them elsewhere they realize how valuable they are. In order for you to make money by buying and selling domains, here are some steps you can take. You can buy domain names from any of the domain sellers. My personal favorite is Namecheap. They make it very easy to send domains to other people. Make sure that the domains you buy are either keyword rich or otherwise very enticing. Advertise your domain name for sale in forums like http://www.namepros.com, http://www.dnforum.com, etc. How much money can I make out of flipping? Your profit can range anything between few dollars to hundreds or thousands of dollars, depending on the domain name you bought and the demand for it. 77 Start flipping websites. Flipping websites is similar to flipping domains. The difference is that instead of immediately turning around and selling a website, you can hold on to it, make some changes, and then sell it as an improved model. You can also hold on to it, make some money from it, and then show potential buyers how much it can make. You can read a great article going into more detail about this here. In order for you to make money by buying and selling domains, here are some steps you can take. Search sites like DN Forum or Flippa to find potential websites to buy. You can also look out for sites on Google, or come across sites while you're browsing, and start contacting owners. After you've adjusted different things on the websites, go back to DN Forum Flippa, or people already established in the website's niche to see if you could find buyers. How much money can I make out of flipping? People have made anywhere from $100 to millions of dollars with flipping. This is highly dependent on the profit that your website makes. 78 Get paid to read emails. There are many sites which pay you for reading emails. These are nothing but advertisement emails from specific companies. You will be required to open those emails and click on the advertisement link provided by the company to get paid. The company that pays you get paid by advertisers to show you their emails. The advertisers hope that when you click over, you'll want to end up buying whatever they're selling. As they share your information with their advertisers, they are paying a portion of their ad revenue with you. In order for you to make money by reading emails, here are some steps you can take. Google Get paid to read emails. Get registered in one or many of the sites that go over this. Some examples are http://www.getpaid5times.com, http://wowearnings.com, etc. Fill out your personal details to complete the registration procedure. Once you start receiving emails, open it and click on the link How much money can I make out of reading emails? You can expect something around 10 cents per email. Other than getting paid for reading emails, you can make money for referring your friends as well. 79. Find products for buyers on eBay. Sometimes people desperately want something on eBay but the search filters aren't working, they're not sure how to search for it, or they don't have time to search themselves, or all of the above. You can help these people by going through eBay on their behalf and getting paid a finder's fee when you find the products they're looking for. In order for you to make money by reading emails, here are some steps you can take. Go through Craigslist wanted ads and ask people if they'd be interested in your services. People that post there often desperately want hard-to-find items. Tell your friends and family about your service. Post in antique forums, record forums, and other niches that have hard-to-find items that people passionately collect. How much money can I make out of filtering products for buyers? You can expect to be paid between $10 through the thousands if you can help people find what they really want. 80. Expert in something? Share your knowledge through your blog/website. Are you truly an expert in any area? Then share your knowledge through your blog or website. In order to get regular followers for your site, you can take a subject on which you are an expert and detail one topic a day on the subject. Once you build traffic for your site, you can earn a lot through advertising revenue. In order for you to make money by sharing your knowledge via a blog or website, here are some steps you can take. Start a website or blog for yourself. Pick up an interesting subject on which you are an expert. Pick up one topic a day on the subject and share it with your users. One idea is to an instructional audio/video detailing it step by step to keep it simple and interesting. Make the contents keyword rich to get more hits for your site. Build traffic for your site and start earning through advertisements. Advertise in websites or forums, social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. How much money can I make? It depends on the traffic you build and the number of advertisers you attract. You can also try to make money via affiliate offers, see number 47. 81 Start writing newsletters and circulate it to build a database. If you're good at writing, An option for you would be to create newsletters and circulate them on a somewhat routine basis. You can circulate them for free at first, but if your newsletters are really interesting and informative, you can build up your subscriber base. After that's done, you can either charge to a paid model where people have to sign up to read your content, or you can just charge advertisers to promote themselves in your newsletter. In order for you to make money by writing a newsletter, here are some steps you can take. Choose a topic that you want to write about. Go to forums which deals with that particular topic. Start participating in those forums to establish yourself as an expert. Create a sign-up page for people to sign up to your newsletter. Circulate your newsletters on a specific routine, either weekly, monthly, bimonthly, etc. As you build up subscribers, contact advertisers and let them know how many people they would have access to if they decided to pay you for advertising. How much money can I make? This will depend on your niche and amount of subscribers, but it wouldn't be unreasonable to ask for $100 or more for an ad going out to 5,000 or more subscribers. 82. Submitting articles to article directories. Submitting articles to article directories is one of the best ways for webmasters to build traffic for their sites. There are hundreds of article directories on the internet, but many website owners only want their articles submitted to the top 25, 50, or 100. As you can imagine, it can take a long time to submit an article to so many directories, especially if someone writes a lot of articles. Because of this, webmasters tend to hire people to submit to article directories on their behalf. In order for you to become an article submitter, here are some steps you can take. Get yourself registered in freelancing sites such as Elance.com, Guru.com, and Odzk.com. Look for article submission jobs and start applying for them. Once you get hired, start submitting to required directories and maintain a log of where you have submitted to and the username and password you used. Get the job completed on time and get paid. How much money can I make? You can earn between $2 to $5 per hour, or earn a flat fee for every X submissions. 83. Link builder. As we explained earlier, backlinks are basically links on other people's websites pointing to another site. When someone links to another person's website, it shows Google that their website is worth linking to, and so Google gives it preference for their search engine placements. The higher the search engine placement, the more publicity a business gets, so a lot of people try hard to get more links to their websites. There is a way to ethically manipulate other websites to giving you links, and if you know how to do that, then you can provide those services for a fee. In order for you to become a link builder, here are some steps you can take. Get yourself registered in freelancing sites such as Elance.com, Guru.com, and Odzk.com. Look for link building jobs and start applying for them. The buyer will often supply you with places to build links to. You would just go to those places and follow whatever instructions the buyer gives you. Sometimes you have to create a profile, other times you have to make blog comments, etc. Once you get hired, start building quality links for your buyer's site. How much money can I make? You can make anything between $2 to $8 per hour depending on your expertise. 84. Find expired domains. When someone buys a domain, they only buy it for a certain time, usually 1, 2, 3, or 5 years. If they forget to renew their domain, or just choose not to, the domains go into a database and you can choose to buy them. This is a cool way to capitalize on sites that already have traffic. Also, older domains generally get higher preference in Google, so you can start out with a site that has a good search engine ranking. You can either build on these sites or flip them to other people for more money. In order for you to make money finding expired domains, here are some steps you can take. Find an expired domain name database. One example is right here. Buy domains. Decide whether you want to improve upon the sites, or just flip them. If you opt to improve them, then make your changes. If you want to flip them, refer to number 77. How much can I make out of finding expired domains? The amount of money you can make would be different in each case. You could have a total loss, total cost, $8.81 if you buy a domain via Namecheap with a coupon code, or you could potentially make into the thousands of dollars. 85 Transcription jobs, there are a lot of circumstances when things need to be transcribed. Some of these instances are when official meetings take place, or someone wants to have a written version of a webinar or video. Because transcription can be quite timely, companies often hire transcriptionists to type out whatever was said. In order for you to become a transcriptionist, here are some steps you can take. Get yourself registered in freelancing sites such as Elance.com, Guru.com, and Odzke.com. Shoot an email to support@BernieOurTotoList.com with what you can do, as they are always looking for more transcriptionists. Get yourself registered in the sites which provide transcription services exclusively, example, http://www.waywithwords.eu, and provide transcription services for their clients if hired. Look for transcription positions and start applying for them. Once you get hired, type up the audio. Make sure it's error-free. How much can I make out of transcription services? You can make anything between $3 to $50 per hour depending on your speed, experience, and expertise. Transcriptionists who can get things done faster are able to charge a premium. 86 Become a mystery shopper. Do you like to shop? Did you know that you can do it with other people's money? Companies hire mystery shoppers to collect information on various things like employee integrity, cleanliness of the store, service provided, the way the employees treats their customers, etc. The companies are in need of such information to identify the problems and improve their services accordingly if required. If you want to learn more, feel free to visit here or here. In order for you to become a mystery shopper, here are some steps you can take. Look for mystery shopper jobs in the internet. Here is one example. Get yourself registered in freelancing sites such as Elance.com, Guru.com, and Odzke.com. Look for mystery shopping jobs within the freelance sites once you get hired. Perform the mystery shopping and make sure to fill out comprehensive reports with your experiences. How much can I make out of such jobs? Many places pay anywhere from $5 to $10 an hour. 87 Provide online homework help. If you are an expert in any subject, start providing online homework help during your spare time and make money out of it. There is constant demand for online tutors who can provide homework help to students. In order for you to make money with online homework help, here are some steps you can take. Browse through the net for online homework help jobs and start applying for it. Two examples are here and here. Start your own website and list down the subjects for which you provide homework help. Advertise in websites or forums, social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. You may want to consider putting your offer on a bulletin board at a nearby school. After getting clients, provide excellent service so you can get more word-of-mouth referral clients. How much money can I make out of such jobs? You can charge anywhere from $3 to $50 per hour depending on your experience and expertise on the subject. Most people charge between $10 to $20. 88 Play online games and make money. There are sites that will pay you real cash for the points you acquire in different games. To involve in serious gaming for cash, make sure that you have the proper graphics card, an upgraded CPU, joystick, and whatever else may be required for the specific game you want to play. To know more about playing games for making money, please refer here. In order for you to make money with online homework help, here are some steps you can take. Run a Google search for Earn Cash to Play Games. You'll find a few sites, including Gamesville and Play for Money. How much money can I make out of such jobs? The amount you earn will depend on the type of game you play. You usually earn a little at a time, but again, if you do this simultaneously with other methods in this book, it can be a nice way to gain relaxation and earn at the same time. 89 Build one website and sell it to lots of people in the niche. If you are good at website design, you can design one main template and sell it to people in the same industry. For example, you can create a template for hairdressers, contact all the hairdressers you know, and then give them the website you created. All you need to do to change up the template is to change the logo, company name, icons, etc. In order for you to make money with this, here are some steps you can take. Design an impressive site for yourself. Include your portfolio and client testimonials. Market your templates by advertising it in various sites. Advertise in websites or forums, social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. Cold call people in the industry that you want to sell websites to. People who don't have websites yet would be a prime market for this. How much money can I make? You can reasonably expect between $50 and $250 for each website you create. 90 pay-per-click arbitrage. PPC arbitrage is when you buy ads on Google AdWords, and then when users click on the ads, they simply see a bunch of advertisements to go to other sites. They click on those advertisements, and you earn income. The difference between the amount you pay to buy the advertisement and the amount you receive per click is the profit you make. To know more about PPC arbitrage, feel free to refer here. In order for you to make money with arbitrage services, here are some steps you can take. Set up a very simple website for yourself. You will use this to direct people to new pages. Purchase some PPC ads on Google AdWords. Set up Google AdWords so that people are redirected to your web page after they click through the ad. Get paid for every click on your ads. Pocket the difference. How much money can I make? This is highly dependent on several factors: the niche you're in, how many ads you have up, how much you're paying for each ad, how much you get paid when people click on your ads, etc. But you can safely assume anywhere from $0.01 to $1. The key with this is to scale to a large degree. 91. A currency trading is similar to stock trading, and just like with stock trading, it's one of the riskier ways to earn money, unless you are well aware of what you are doing. However, once you get familiar with it and understand when to buy or sell currencies, then you can make a lot of profit out of it. Feel free to read more here for more information. In order for you to make money with a currency trading, here are some steps you can take. Analyze the current market before you buy or sell any currency. Keep watching the market to buy or sell currencies at the right time. Take advice from experts in the area if required. How much money can I make? It depends on the currencies you hold and the decisions you make. This can potentially be very lucrative, though of course it can also be a major loss for you. 92. Expert in something? Get paid by becoming a guide in about.com. If you are an expert in any subject matter, then you can become one of the guides in about.com. To become a guide in about.com, you need to browse through their available topics and apply for the topics that you are an expert in. You will have to go through their filtering process before getting hired, and then if they choose you as one of the guides, you need to undergo their online training. You can learn more about this by going here. In order for you to make money with about.com, here are some steps you can take. Apply here. How much money can I make by becoming an about.com guide? Straight from the website, in addition to a base payment, guaranteed to be $675 per month for guides in their first 2 years, with a minimum of $500 per month afterwards, about.com pays guides by measuring page view growth, month over month for guides in their first year, and year over year every year after, with payment incentives for page view growth. If your page views grow, you will never make less than $675 per month. This is a nice way to get money in addition to using the other methods we have gone over. 93. Is your website successful? Make it a subscription website. If you have managed to build enough traffic for your site, consider making it a subscription website. A subscription site is one in which people have to pay in order to view the content on it. This will only work if you have a strong follower base, since there are millions of sites that have free content, but it is definitely something to consider. In order for you to make money with a subscription website, here are some steps you can take. Choose a niche for yourself and start a website. Keep writing interesting content within the niche you have chosen. Participate in user forums which talks about your niche. Build your credibility by publishing only quality content. Keep posting contents on daily basis as long as possible. Over a period of time you can build regular followers for your site. After that is done, you can convert your site into a subscription site and start earning. How much can I make out of it? You can play around with the numbers, but even $5 or $10 a month adds up very quickly. 94 Review websites for a fee. If you have a popular website with lots of traffic, you can start reviewing sites in your niche for a fee. A lot of people would love to leverage your traffic and would be more than happy to pay you to give them more exposure. If you do this, make sure to provide honest and in-depth reviews about both the good aspects and the flaws. This is also a nice way to get products for free. Smiley face. In order for you to make money by reviewing websites, here are some steps you can take. Post an ad on your website saying that you are taking new clients for reviews. If your website is popular, that alone could be enough. Do a search on Google and approach the websites in your niche. Websites that aren't high in the search engines might be eager to get more traffic, and websites that already are high may still want more. The more offers you send, the better your results. Make sure to mention your website traffic numbers if you decide to send out emails. How much can I make out of it? This will depend on how much traffic you get and what your niche is in. You can charge anywhere from $50 to $500 for each review you do. 95 Consultant services. As an extension to website review services, once you gain enough experience and expertise in reviewing websites and blogs, you can start an upgrade service by providing professional reports to websites. You can review their sites and let them know what needs to be fixed, what has worked the best for other websites, and what you think can be improved upon. In order for you to make money with consultant services, here are some steps you can take. Post an ad on your website saying that you are taking new clients for reviews. If your website is popular, that alone could be enough. Contact your old clients and let them know you're offering private reviews that don't have to be posted for all of the public to see. Do a search on Google and approach the websites in your niche. Websites that aren't high in the search engines might be eager to get more traffic, and websites that already are high may still want more. The more offers you send, the better your results. Make sure to mention your website traffic numbers if you decide to send out emails. How much money can I make? You can charge from $100 per review and upwards. 96 Right landing page for websites. A landing page is the first page a visitor sees when they click on a company's website. These pages are very important to webmasters since most people decide if they're going to stay on a website within 5 seconds of getting there. A good landing page needs to look compelling, but also have all the elements that Google wants, keyword rich and so forth, so that it's picked up by the search engines and stays high on the search results. If you can create the right combination of attractiveness and Google savvy, you can earn a lot of money. This is actually a lot easier than it sounds. In order for you to make money with writing landing pages, here are some steps you can take. Get yourself registered in freelancing sites such as Elance.com, Guru.com, and Odesk.com. Look for openings which ask for SEO experts and start applying for them. Once you get hired, write a search engine optimized and attractive landing page. How much can I make out of such services? If you become an expert in this, you can reasonably expect between $10 to $15 per hour depending on your experience and expertise. 97 Sell your idle CPU cycles. When you have downtime and aren't going to be using your computer, you can sell your CPU cycle. To do this, you need to get registered and get client software installed in your computer. The client will in turn pay you back. To know more about this, feel free to go here or here. In order for you to make money with selling your idle CPU cycles, here are some steps you can take. Go here and sign up for an account. You can read all the details right here. How much money can I make? You can specify how much you want, but the going rate right now is about 3 cents an hour. This is just something you can do in addition to the other methods here. 98 Sell ringtones by composing MIDI. A MIDI is a musical instrument digital interface that allows interaction between electronic musical instruments and computerized devices, which allows you to record and play back music. If you can compose good music through MIDI, then you can sell your music as ringtones. To understand more, please refer here, here, or here. One of the sample sites to record MIDI, http://www.anvilstudio.com/fcompose.htm. In order for you to make money with selling ringtones, here are some steps you can take. Read the information, refer here, here, or here. Go here to record your MIDIs, or run a Google search for record MIDI, find places to sell your ringtones. Popular sites to sell include Lulu, Mixer, and Scenetone. For these sites, you will typically be paid via PayPal. Add your ringtones. You can also create a website and refer your friends and family there. Advertise in websites or forums, social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. How much money can I make? You can make anywhere from a few cents to a few dollars per ringtone you sell. The key would be to sell in bulk. You can also increase your chances of selling by including wallpaper to go along with the ringtones, possibly for free. 99. Sell CD mixes. There are thousands of sites online which offer free audio or video downloads that you can legally download and use. You can take the best songs from there and create different CD mixes to sell. People may either buy them for personal use or as gifts. Not only can the CD mixes be heartfelt, but they're also a great way to support independent artists. You could also consider creating custom mixes for people. In order for you to make money with selling CD mixes, here are some steps you can take. Google open source music. You can also go here to find a blog post outlining 13 of the best sources for open source music. Start playing around and creating music. Tell your friends and family about your service. Advertise in websites or forums, social networks, amongst friends, or via other traffic methods. You can outsource a lot of this to burn your to-do list if you don't have the time or know-how. How much money can I make? You could reasonably charge $10 or $15 for a regular CD and $30 or more for a custom CD. You would just need to subtract the amount of money it costs to buy and ship the CD to get your overall profit. 100 Become an SEO consultant. Search engine optimization is the process of helping websites get onto the top of Google. So for example, when someone types in San Diego Baker, every San Diego Baker would want to show up on the top 10 of Google's results. An SEO consultant would help make that happen. As an SEO consultant, you would look at different elements of a client's website and work with them to get their site SEO friendly. You can get a full brief on SEO on the Wikipedia entry. In order for you to become an SEO consultant, here are some steps you can take. Create a website for yourself. Show samples of what you've been able to do before with search engine results. To get clients, you may want to type in certain search terms and approach clients who are not already at the top and you think you can help. You can also find SEO consultant positions on Elance.com, Guru.com, and Odesk.com. How much money can I make? If you are an expert with proven track record, you can make an hourly rate. The minimum would be $10 an hour, or a set price every time a website goes to the top, $500 or more. You may want to start off with lower prices in the beginning to establish a track record and then go up as you learn more. Conclusion: I hope you enjoyed this report. Smiley face. We tried to find different ways of making money for all types of people, and I sincerely hope that some of these resonated with you. Remember that you can mix and match these methods if you want. Some of them don't make as much money, but because they're fun, they're a nice thing to add to your repertoire. Please review the resources page on the next page to learn about some of the best ways you can support your goals. Thanks for listening, please like and subscribe to the channel.